Bubba Wallace has become one of the most recognizable names in NASCAR, and he has two rides to choose from for 2021. Which contract should he take? We're going to talk about that in today's video. How's it going, y'all? My name is Eric, and welcome to Out of the Groove. I hope you had a good weekend. NASCAR silly season conversation continues to heat up. In the last week, Brad Keselowski has signed a one-year extension with Team Penske. Joe Gibbs has revealed that Eric Jones will not be back in the 20 car, and it sounds like Christopher Bell will be his replacement. And now, in this past weekend, Bubba Wallace shared some hints at his potential landing spot for 2021. According to NBC Sports, during the broadcast yesterday, Bubba Wallace has contract offers from not only Richard Petty Motorsports, his current team, which does include an increased ownership stake in the team, but he also, again, according to Marty Snyder from NBC Sports, has a contract offer from Chip Ganassi Racing to drive the 42 car next year. So we're going to talk about that. I'm going to weigh the pros and cons of both situations, and I'm going to tell you guys what I think Bubba Wallace should choose. But first, let's start at the beginning of the weekend. Bubba Wallace ran ninth in the first race at Michigan on Saturday. Great run for that team, one of their best performances of the season. And during his post-race interview, Bubba Wallace teased a possible major deal just on the horizon, but he wasn't super specific about what the deal itself actually is. So that's led myself, as well as many other fans this weekend, to speculate, where's Bubba Wallace going next year?
Say a prayer for us. Everybody say a prayer for us. There's a big deal on the line right now, and this could only help so much. I have yet to check my phone to see the status of it, but
okay.
This will send us over the top if we can get it done. So it's been a lot of hard work off the racetrack for my team, everybody involved, to make things better, and that's what we're trying to do. So putting solid runs together, having awesome restarts all night, this is only going to help the effort. So I'm definitely smiling, so it's a good deal.
And now, he said all that between breaths just after complimenting his Richard Petty Motorsports team on the work they've put in to help them run top 10 at Michigan International Speedway. So with that context in mind, a lot of people were speculating who Bubba Wallace is referring to when he uses the phrase, my team. Is he referring to Richard Petty Motorsports? Is he referring to, like, his management team working on other contract deals elsewhere? Because of all the praise he gave Richard Petty Motorsports in the breath before that quote, I took it more as he's talking about Richard Petty Motorsports. I mean, how he's talking about how top 10 runs like that only help hit the team. I assume the effort is referring to Richard Petty Motorsports. It seems weird to me that Bubba Wallace would compliment Richard Petty Motorsports like that, talk about how good their momentum is, and then immediately turn around and talk about how he's excited to leave the team. But Bubba Wallace has always been quite outspoken. He often says things, and I don't know, maybe it was just kind of a slip up in that way. So he definitely could be referring to his management team, and with the news Sunday coming out that he apparently does have an offer from Chip Ganassi Racing, it sounds like Bubba Wallace has still not made up his mind as to what deal he's going to take. So like I said earlier, during the race yesterday on NBCSN, Marty Snyder reported that Bubba Wallace told him that he has a contract offer from Chip Ganassi Racing to drive the 42 car. This comes a couple weeks after reports sort of surfaced that Chip Ganassi Racing was interested in Wallace, partially at least because both Chip Ganassi Racing and Bubba Wallace share McDonald's as a main sponsor. Now, another interesting thing that was noted by Marty Snyder during the NBCSN broadcast yesterday is that apparently Bubba Wallace has already had an ownership stake in Richard Petty Motorsports since the start of 2019. Remember, a couple weeks ago, Andrew Murstein, the co-owner at Richard Petty Motorsports, told the media that he had offered Bubba Wallace an increased ownership stake in Richard Petty Motorsports. Reports said it was in the 10 to 20% range. But according to Bubba Wallace, he already owned a smaller percentage of the team since last year, something that I guess nobody really realized to this point. But Andrew Murstein, remember a couple weeks ago, sounded very optimistic that he was going to be able to get Bubba Wallace to sign an extension with the team to take that deal, and perhaps the increased ownership stake was only there to sweeten the deal and perhaps further entice Bubba Wallace to take that offer. And I said it last week, and I still believe that the reason Murstein kind of added that, you know, increased ownership to the contract is probably because he knew Chip Ganassi Racing and maybe other teams were looking in and possibly throwing offers Bubba Wallace's way as well. And Murstein, Richard Petty Motorsports, had to sweeten the deal to ensure they kept their driver, who also brings a lot of sponsorship to that team, in-house for the 2021 season. But this definitely changes things a little bit. The fact that Bubba Wallace has already owned a part of Richard Petty Motorsports for a year and a half, and the fact that he's still seeking other options potentially, makes it sound like maybe he's not as tied down to that organization as people want you to believe. And now that Bubba Wallace is actually going out publicly stating that he has an offer from Chip Ganassi Racing, something that most drivers do not do. You do not see drivers go out and publicly talk about what offers they have. But now that we know that Bubba Wallace has an offer from Chip Ganassi Racing, the question has to be asked, which ride should he take? What situation makes the most sense for Bubba Wallace going forward? Bubba Wallace is only in his third full-time Cup Series season. He's only 26 years old, still one of the younger drivers in the Cup Series garage. He still has many years of racing ahead of him, but up to this point, he has not been in top NASCAR Cup Series equipment. So this next deal that he signs for 2021 and beyond is extremely important. So let's look at these two options, the 42 versus the 43 car. On the surface, clearly the 42 car is at least a slightly better car. Chip Ganassi Racing is a two-car organization. Richard Petty Motorsports is a one-car team, which up until, you know, middle of last year, sponsorship and funding was very much a question for the 43 team. But the 42 car is more competitive than the 43 without a doubt. I mean, Kyle Larson wheeled that thing to four straight top 10 points finishes from 2016 to 2019. Meanwhile, Bubba Wallace, now in his third year with Richard Petty Motorsports, has been unable to crack the top 25 in points. Now this year, they are right now, I think, 20th in points. So this year has actually been a huge improvement over the previous 2 years, but still at least a little bit off of what I think most people expect out of the 42 car. However, I do think those stats I just told you can be deceiving. Yes, the 42 car, the last 4 years, has made the playoffs, has made it at least to the round of 12 in the playoffs, you know, won a race last year, won the All-Star race last year as well. But Kyle Larson was the driver, and I know Kyle Larson's transition into the NASCAR Cup Series hasn't been super smooth, but if you've paid any attention to his dirt racing escapade over the last several months, he is undisputed. Kyle Larson is a fantastic driving talent. And I think if we look back at his Cup Series, you know, career up to this point, who knows if it'll continue beyond, you know, the future. I think it's safe to say Kyle Larson was getting the most out of that 42 car that he could possibly get, that anyone could maybe possibly get. I think you put Kyle Busch, you put Kevin Harvick in that 42 car the last 3 or 4 years, like Larson's been in it, I think the results would be similar. Maybe Busch and Harvick, because they come from stock car racing, they have a little bit more of that background experience, maybe would have run a little better than Larson did, but I don't think they would have run much better than Larson did. The 42 car, my point is not a Joe Gibbs car. It's not a Penske car or a Stuart Haas car. It's closer to like a Hendrick car. I think in general, the Chevrolets are just not quite as good as the Fords and Toyotas right now, and Chip Ganassi Racing is certainly no different. I might even put them slightly behind Hendrick. It's up and down week to week. So when I factor in the data that suggests Kyle Larson was getting more out of that car than most other drivers were getting out of their car, it leads you to wonder whether the 42 car really is that much better than the 43. It's definitely better. I don't want it to sound like they're equal. I think it's definitely a better car, but I think Kyle Larson was overselling it for a few years there. I mean, look at the other Chip Ganassi Racing car with Kurt Busch behind the wheel. Kurt Busch is a former series champion. Before he joined Chip Ganassi Racing at the start of the 2019 season, he was a 30-time winner in the NASCAR Cup Series. And now he's been with Chip Ganassi for a year and a half. He's run 58 races. He has one win. He's certainly been very consistent in that car, consistently in the top 10, top 12 on a fairly regular basis. Last year, we all talked about how big of a surprise his performance was in the one car. But the reason we're talking about that being a surprise is because the several years prior, the one car wasn't that good. Jamie McMurray was driving it, and he didn't win any races in the one car his final 5 seasons in the Cup Series. He was a mid-teens driver at the end of his career in the one car. So replace Jamie McMurray, a decent driver, but not a Hall of Famer, with a Hall of Famer like Kurt Busch is, a former champion, and obviously the one car's performance has picked up. But now this is where the question about Bubba Wallace comes into play. I don't think Bubba Wallace is as good as Kyle Larson or Kurt Busch. I don't think Bubba Wallace is bad. I think he is a decent driver who still has room to grow, room to learn. I think is still improving. But as of right now, he is not as good of a driver as Kurt Busch or Kyle Larson. That's my opinion. So while Kyle Larson and Kurt Busch have consistently been able to run top 10, top 12, snag a win occasionally in those cars, is Bubba Wallace going to be capable of doing that? I just don't know. Bubba Wallace has had some good numbers in his career. Back in 2014, when he was driving full-time in the Truck Series for Kyle Busch Motorsports, he won 4 races that year and finished 3rd in the points. I mean, that's a pretty good season. However, then in 2015 and 2016, he ran full-time Xfinity for Roush Fenway and didn't win any races those years. Meanwhile, his teammate Chris Buescher in 2015 went on to win the championship. So I know Roush Fenway was struggling with funding towards the end there. I understand that the situation was not perfect for Bubba Wallace, but if you look at the stats, it wasn't a great couple of years for Bubba Wallace, unfortunately. But when he filled in for Eric Almirola in 2017, after Almirola was injured at Kansas, Bubba Wallace put together some really solid runs that year. And then once he took over the car full-time starting in 2018, he's had a few standout performances, finishing 2nd in the Daytona 500 that year. He's run well at some of the short tracks. He snagged some top 5s, some top 10s here and there. So Bubba Wallace has put together some pretty good seasons. And this year, with improved equipment over there at the 43 team, he's cracked the top 20 in points. Point is, I think Bubba Wallace is a decent Cup Series driver, but I do not think he's as good as Kurt Busch and Kyle Larson, the most recent drivers Chip Ganassi has had. I'm not talking about Matt Kenseth here, because Matt Kenseth, while I think he's historically been a very good driver. He's also the oldest driver in the Cup Series right now and had not been in a race car for a year and a half and has had no practice or qualifying. So Matt Kenseth, maybe that is something to look at. Matt Kenseth is running 18th most weeks in this car. Is that really maybe what the 42 car is actually capable of? And maybe Larson was just getting more out of it? I don't know. And I do think that's something that Bubba Wallace should take a look at. I mean, Kurt Busch and Matt Kenseth are not contending for wins this year. They're really not even close. So how much better is the 42 car really than the 43? I think it's a little bit better, but I don't think it's as good as Kyle Larson and Kurt Busch have made those Chip Ganassi Racing cars out to be the last couple of seasons. But it's still an improvement from the 43 car, so it might be the best option for Bubba Wallace if those are the two contracts he has on his desk. Although also keep in mind that Chip Ganassi Racing just fired Chad Johnston, who'd been the crew chief on that 42 car for 4.5 years. So yeah, the future of that car may still be a little uncertain at the moment. So I don't know, that's something Bubba Wallace I'm sure is keeping in mind, and that's why this isn't a no-brainer decision for him. So now that I've talked about Chip Ganassi, I want to focus on Richard Petty Motorsports. If you remember that original quote from earlier this weekend, he talked about some sort of major deal being in the works, some sort of huge thing that's going to put them over the top, is what he said. If he's referring to Richard Petty Motorsports, could this crazy new deal that he's excited for involve a new technical alliance? Could it be a huge investor coming in? Could it be a new big sponsor? A partial ownership stake by itself in Richard Petty Motorsports is definitely worth something. But I think if I'm Bubba Wallace, I would be hoping for some sort of increased investment in that overall program before I sign that contract. If Bubba Wallace goes to another team like Chip Ganassi Racing, that doesn't necessarily guarantee the same stability that he might get if he was, you know, an owner, a partial owner at Richard Petty Motorsports. If he owns 20%, if he owns a quarter of that team, to me that means he's got a ride at Richard Petty Motorsports as long as they stay in the Cup Series. If he goes to Chip Ganassi or goes to another team, you know, times are tough. Teams make decisions with a snap of the finger like that, and you know, Bubba Wallace's career could be cut short. I mean, even Danica Patrick, even her sponsorship started to dry up after 3 or 4 years in the Cup Series. So while Bubba Wallace may have a lot of momentum behind his name right now, a lot of sponsors backing him, a lot of funding, it can go away pretty quickly, as we've seen with other superstar big-name drivers in the past. But if he becomes a 20% or more owner in Richard Petty Motorsports, there's a good chance he's going to have a ride there as long as that team stays in business. But focusing on Richard Petty Motorsports, you do have to think long-term. Remember, the next-gen car is set to debut in 2022, and the next-gen car is going to shrink the competition gap between the biggest and wealthiest teams and the smaller teams, just a little bit. It's not going to put Richard Petty Motorsports on the same even playing field as Joe Gibbs Racing, but it's going to narrow that gap a little bit. Right now, you know, Joe Gibbs spends a ton of money developing and building their own cars, their own chassis. Richard Petty Motorsports doesn't spend nearly as much. With the next-gen car promising to give everyone the exact same chassis, that's one important component of competition that's now going to be kind of even. Joe Gibbs Racing is still going to likely get better manufacturer support, likely have a better engine program, better people working on their cars. So Joe Gibbs Racing would still have an advantage over a team like Richard Petty Motorsports, but it's going to shrink. It is going to shrink when we go to a spec car in 2022. If I'm Bubba Wallace looking at the long-term future, I don't think it looks too bad for Richard Petty Motorsports. It's never going to become a powerhouse team like Joe Gibbs Racing, but I would say it could get to Chip Ganassi level. And while at Chip Ganassi, you're just going to be a driver, at Richard Petty, you're going to be the driver, partial owner. You're going to have a lot of say in what goes on over there. I don't know Bubba Wallace. I don't know if that kind of control or, you know, influence is really important to him, or if he really just wants to go out and win races as quick as possible. If that's the case, if you just want to go win races maybe next year, Chip Ganassi is probably the better bet. But if Bubba Wallace is really thinking big picture, 5-10 years down the line, I'm not kidding. I can't believe I'm saying this, but Richard Petty Motorsports might be the more stable option. It's a tricky situation, and we don't even know yet if these are the only two contracts Bubba Wallace is going to be offered this season. That big deal he was teasing during his interview this past week, it might be completely unrelated to these two contracts. That could be a Hendrick Motorsports deal that suddenly shows up. That could be, well, a fourth Penske car. I mean, I'd probably not, but you know, I'm just saying, he's teasing a big deal. It may not even be one of the two things we just spent, you know, 12, 15 minutes talking about, but only time will tell. This is extremely interesting because Bubba Wallace, he's a huge personality for the sport. He's been in the public eye quite a bit. There's a lot of misinformation, unfortunately, about him and about his character that's being spread out there. But Bubba Wallace is what NASCAR desperately needs, a major personality that's more or less become a household name in NASCAR, something that NASCAR has been lacking since Dale Earnhardt Jr. retired. He's going to be a villain to some. He's going to be a hero to many as well. So Bubba Wallace is the kind of driver NASCAR needs more of. Now, I just hope Bubba Wallace is actually good. And actually, if he gets in good equipment next year, I hope he does well. Like I said earlier, I think it's a toss-up. I don't really know how good Bubba Wallace is. I think he's decent, but I don't know if he's ever going to be a consistent winner or a consistent championship threat like some other drivers have been. So that's what I'm hoping for next. I hope Bubba Wallace is really, really good and turns out to grow immensely. I hope Bubba Wallace makes a good decision here. I hope he gets a good ride for next season. I hope he makes a smart move that keeps him in competitive equipment for a long, long time. I hope he makes the most of it once he does get in competitive equipment, but there you have it. There's the silly season update for today. I have a feeling announcement regarding Christopher Bell to the 20, which sounds like it's been confirmed, but hasn't actually been announced by JGR. I have a feeling that's going to come any day. I think Bubba Wallace is likely going to make a decision any day now on his future. So we're still going to have a lot more to talk about, I have a feeling, in the next few weeks, but that's going to do it for today. Thank you all, as always, for watching. Be sure to subscribe if you are new to the channel. Follow me on Twitter, follow me on Instagram, continue the conversation over there. Of course, a huge thank you to my amazing Patreon supporters. I could not do this show without your continued support, so thank you all for supporting the channel and helping out of the groove. Keep uploading almost daily. It's been a busy few weeks, but it's been a lot of fun as well. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I will see you all again very, very soon. Take care, everyone. See you in the next upload.